To help carry on our important work, I want you to join the secret squadron and wear this official badge and have this secret decoder.
So I'm Mike Schneider, a postdoctoral fellow at the center this academic year. So much of my research is within the history and philosophy of physics, with a particular emphasis on the intermingling of large-scale cosmology and fundamental physics research. I also do work in the social epistemology of science with a fondness for formal modeling approaches, as well as historical and anthropological casework. What do I mean by intermingling of cosmology and fundamental physics research? Well, as a matter of practice, large-scale cosmology has been intimately tied up with ongoing fundamental physics research since really the 1920s, when relativistic cosmology got going. So as the name suggests, relativistic cosmology is an appropriation of the tools provided by our current theory of gravity, general relativity. It's an appropriation of those tools to do cosmology. So to study our universe as a whole, as it presents itself to us, at least as it presents itself to us at the largest accessible scales. So I say the largest accessible scales, but really these are often just as well the smallest accessible scales when it comes to trying to reconstruct what we think is going on way out there or way back in cosmic time. So throughout the history of relativistic cosmology, problems that arise in our attempts to understand the large-scale universe, they've motivated projects in fundamental physics. Likewise, our evolving thinking about fundamental physics influences how we think about our universe as a whole. One example from the history of relativistic cosmology might be our thinking about nuclear processes in the high energy early universe. So we now, but not always, take for granted that sufficiently far back, the universe was energetic enough to support a semi-classical theory of element production. Something like what we have also come to know goes on in stars. Another example, so currently, dark energy and cold dark matter are sometimes thought to be clues about quantum gravity. That's the holy grail of the past century of fundamental physics research and theory development. Now, the idea here is that quantum gravity reigns supreme in the earliest moments of our cosmic history, or else it reigns at the smallest spatial scales throughout all of cosmic history. So maybe something in the dark sector, as teased out by our standard model of large-scale cosmology, maybe that'll lead to a breakthrough in our thinking about quantum gravity. So in some respects, this is just to say that fundamental physicists look to mine developments in cosmology to help generate new insights. But the relationship is really more tightly knit than that picture would do justice. So if we start thinking about the very early universe, the distinction between the two domains very nearly disappears. For instance, something I'm working on while a postdoctoral fellow at the center this year is the philosophy surrounding transplanckian censorship. Now, this is a new subject to have come out of string theory research in fundamental physics. In fact, first about a year ago. So the subject, which is really a conjecture, it was immediately taken as cause to theorize about physics in the earliest moments of cosmic history. And the reason being something to do with inflation. So inflation is the fundamental physics community's longstanding favorite account of structure formation in the early universe. But inflationary accounts pair somewhat poorly with this new conjecture, at least as a general rule. So if you'd like the new conjecture, that could force your hand about inflation and lead you to want a different account, structure formation. Or the opposite, this is what I'm pressing, you can think of the conjecture as converting inflation in the early universe into an empirical constraint in quantum gravity research. And that could be construed as problematic for string theory, understood as an approach to developing quantum gravity. So the walls between the two domains of research, cosmology and fundamental physics, are porous, to say the least.